Hello, people of the Earth, and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda, the Ocarina of Time. I am Aki Forrest, and this is part 16. So, I ended off last episode on a cliffhanger. It was good enough for me. Wasn't the best one I've ever had, but hey. But yes, I have become young again. Ah, it's like I don't know. What comparison I was trying to make there when one is trying to feel young? I don't know. I started collecting lots of toys and played with them. That's how you become young again. But yes, we have gone back 7 years. I have a few errands to do. Oh wait, it's night time. Okay, this is going to complicate matters over here. Seeing as I don't have a particular song, which is it's going to remind me to do, because what I was going to do is get another song. I seem to have acquired a couple since I said that last time. But, don't worry. The one I need is the one I actually need. Actually, I could probably just... Shall I wait here? Have I bashed into this tree yet? Ah! I found you, Mr. Bomb. Didn't want to do that. And it didn't blow him up. Fuck. Right, get your controls back into full swing. There is a... Sculpture right in that tree. Where's the fucking moon? He should be around here somewhere. Oh good, he's going down. It's very quick, yeah. The times of day, time literally flies in this place. Like badly. I need to wait until it's daytime so I can actually exit the castle because the drawbridge is currently up. And we're in the castle grounds, so. I need the sun to be up so I can escape from this terrible place called Tel Hyrule Castle. It's got full of Hyrule kings and Ganondorfs and that are yet to be powerful and Zeldas that I happen to be attracted to. Right, that cuckoo. The alarm from the cock signifies that it's morning. Or at least daytime. We're in the daylight hours of the day. So now I can depart. I need, because what I'm gonna do, or shall I? I don't want to spoil. I've always said that until I get a song or an item, I'm not gonna spoil anything about me getting said item or song. So I'm sticking to it. So I'm getting a song, but it's gonna help. I've also got another errand to do as a young boy. I can actually do... The song I'm going to get is... I can do as both an adult and a child, but it's better to do it as a kid. I don't know why. More dramatic. But there's definitely something I need to do as a kid. If you remember, cast your mind back a few parts ago, way before the fucking water temple, which I'm glad is behind me, when we first became an adult, and we went here, we went to go and see the gravekeeper. And he gave us a thing, the hook shot, and then we ended up in the windmill. And the guy in the windmill said, 7 years ago, this kid came in here and played this song. And he taught us the song. So, what I need to do and to keep continuity with that, is that as a kid, I'm going to go into the windmill 7 years ago. It's called question mark, but it's a windmill. And I'm going to play This is a Beautiful Song. I think it's down, up, yep. Da 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 la 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 la. And then this is going to up the windmill and do something magical. Because that's what the guy said when we were an adult. The kid came in and played this song and messed up everything. But, if you remember on the last episode, a monster came out of the well. And Cheek and myself got manhandled, pretty much, by it. Some unspeakable evil force at the bottom of the well. And the best thing about this part is things are going to get spoopy. Because I've got to go into the bottom of the well, where the creature came from. As a kid, can't go down there as an adult, it's all blocked up, so I have to go down there as a kid. But before we do the spoopiness, there's another bit of spoopiness I need to do. It's all spoopy from here on. Because the song that I require, that I need to get, is at the back here of the graveyard. And as you can see, the weather gets kind of atrocious. Check. The crest of the royal family of Hyrule is inscribed here. Well then, let me play this magical song. That's not it. hold on. Let me try that again. There we go. Got my buttons back. Good. And then mysterious forces awaken. My voice has gone all squeaky once more. And we have a hole in the ground where the royal family tomb was. We're gonna go into the hole. This is the royal family's tomb. And I'm already hearing music that says to me, an enemy is nearby. Oh, it's my old friend the boomerang. I have missed you so. Oh, this place looks real nice. I want to have my honeymoon down here. Jesus. With all the bats and the skeleton dudes.
Wouldn't that be romantic?
It's so lovely. There's another bat in here. Somewhere. Oh wait, there. There. And conveniently they're not flying around. They'll just perch themselves on the walls. That's nice. Hello, skeleton. He ain't talking to me. Those who break into the royal tomb will be obstructed by the lurkers in the dark. I've still got a little bit of a throaty voice, but it's making a grand recovery, luckily, so I can talk a bit better than I used to be able to, but I can still put on an evil voice. For some reason, Naffy seems very fascinated by whatever's over there, but we're marching on. La 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 la. Well then, I hear strange noises. Oh, hello. Oh, hello. Right. Remember those horrible things in Wind Waker called Re-Deads? Oh, hello. And they screamed like elephants at me? This is what these guys are in this game, except their scream is less ear-piercing. They just go, ah! But they still freeze you still. But that's what they are. What is this? This poem is dedicated to the memory of the dearly departed members of the royal family. It goes like this. Go away. The rising sun will eventually set, a newborn's life will fade. From sun to moon, moon to sun, give peaceful rest to the living dead. This is an interesting poem. Huh? Something is inscribed on the tombstone. It's the secret melody of the composer brothers. Da 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 we're the composer brothers. Composing's our gang. Our game. Keep the sun song in your heart. Right, so it's... There you go. Got it. One. Got it. If I get it straight off the bat, we've done good. And the analog stick is working. Because I always try it with the analog stick first, and then I resort to using the buttons. Because the buttons are everywhere. You've learned the sun song. And as it kind of taught us right there, what the sun song does... restless souls wander where they don't belong. Bring them calm with the sun song. So yes, this is an easy escape. Not that it wasn't very hard getting in, but it'll make it easier. Because these zombies in here, I can play the sun song again. Which is, whoa. Well, that definitely messed up. Oh, we'll stop and start again. So what the sun song does is it not only, this is going to be a regular tune that does stuff, but it can disable the re-deads around here. Hello, guys. Sorry, I'm going. But not only that, it has more mysterious power because it can change night to day and day to night. So if ever I need a moment where I need to change the time of day, if I need it to be night or if I need it to be day, I can change it if I happen to be in the opposite. In the opposite position. There's another place I can put magic beans. You want some magic beans? And here's the actual gravekeeper now, still alive. See, you recognize him? He was the one floating around down in his grave saying, would you like to race me? I'll give you my prize position. Whatever. Why am I talking like this? I'll never know. But now we've done that. It's time to depart. That being said, it's time to depart. Into... dark, narrow, scary, well of three features. Because we're going... to the bottom... of the well. Man, gotta be over 18 to watch this. It's too scary. Here we are. The glorious. The bottom of the well. Mwahaha. See, I can only come in here as a kid anyway, because Link, adult Link, can't crawl through these little gaps. But little Link can. That's what I think I'll call him from now on. I shall call him Little Link, because he is one. He is Little Link. He little Link. Oh, hi there. You're looking awfully intimidating, Mr. Big Dude Spider. Hold on, wait until my... Let me get my DQ sticks out. It's been a while. Yeah, okay, thank you. Bah! I slapped him good with that stick. With my slapstick. What does this say? It doesn't say anything. What are you doing? Right, before I do this bit of magic, I'm just gonna go... Right, there's a little bit of magic I could do here. I don't know why nothing is being said here exactly, but it should be. But I'm gonna do a bit of magic. You ready? 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 Woo! I'm on the other side of the fucking wall! And I managed to do that! That's because that wall is fake. Why don't I get out that? Hit it with a sword. Yes, we are going to get, this is the other reason I need to come here first before we go into the Shadow Temple, because I'm going to obtain a certain item in here, which is going to allow me to see these fake walls. Sorry, I'm revealing items. I said I wouldn't on this same very part a few moments ago. But I may as well just let it out of the box right now, because you're all probably wondering what the fuck I just did there. And that's what I did. I just went through a fake wall. Right, I need to drown this place. So we need to go... or undrown this place. This guy here happens to be flooding everything by spewing up water. The ungrateful bastard. Right, whoa! Right, and before I go through any more magical walls, I knew he was going to be coming around. Whoops, I fell down. Whoops, that was not part of the plan. Oh, well, I'm down here now. Pots of things. I don't need any more hearts. I need money, because I fell down now. Whoops, I wasn't... Yeah, so as you can tell, this place is full of... fake walls and invisible walls and walls that aren't supposed to be there.
Big day for a fan of walls.
But are. So, unfortunately. I was supposed to go... This is like a bonus dungeon. There's not like... You know, like the ice caverns were. Oh god. Hold on. I'm going up the ladder. Go away. Ugh. Yeah, this is a place just to acquire additional bonuses and whatnot, so I don't actually need to go all through it. I just needed to lower the water in here, because I've had enough of water on this game. Oh, wait, I can't go up there until... Oh, fuck, I need to go and collect all these things to go through the door. Fuck. Looks like our journey into the bottom of the well is going to be long rather than short. And I'll go it even lower down. And more lower down. There's too many ladders in here to go down. Then again, who's to say which way a ladder dictates where you're going? Right, I'm gonna do the sun song again. There! Fuck. Hey, finally got it. It's not my fault. If I was playing on any other controller, it would be away straight off the bat. Right, now I've got to slash the crap out of him with these sticks. Yeah. Ah, no! He's going to rape me! Ah! Yeah. Get rid of him. The reason I was hitting them with the sticks is they're actually more powerful than my sword. Yeah, I'm a wuss. But for some reason they make more damage. Right, we need to collect all of the things down here. I'm certainly not used to this. Okay, they're all in the middle here. Because that is the only way up, is through that door. Every one of these other passageways just leads off somewhere else. To booby traps. This place is evil. But yeah, the Shadow Temple is also full of these walls that aren't really walls. And other stuff that may be invisible to the human eye. So that's why we're in this place, so I know where the fuck everything is. Right, hold on a minute. I seem to be in another case of, I think this fake wall is here. Yeah, good. Right, I think I'm back at the beginning. Yes, I am. Good. Right, what we need to do is go down here. This is where the water was filling up that I've gotten rid of. So now we can crawl underneath here. Oh, hi there. Didn't see ya. You're intimidating fuel. Right. Don't worry, when I'm an adult, those guys won't be so intimidating, hit them with one blow with my sword. Right, this room looks intriguing. A bunch of arms sticking out of the fucking floor. I wonder if I should let one of them grab a hold of me. I've got to anyway. You don't get a vote. Because if I do, this guy comes up. He is weird as foe. Weird as mofo. Right, you're going to have some stick when you get your head down here. Fuck you. Yeah. Alright, come here. Okay, don't come here. Go away. Okay, grab the hand again. He appeared right next to me. No. Oh god. He's grabbing a hold of me again. Get off. Well, at least I was able to hit him with that. God, one more stick. He's getting the wrong end of this. He's not barking up the wrong tree. He's barking up the right tree. Right into my stick. How many more stick puns and jokes can I make? Okay, get your stick out again. Don't show it off though. It's not that impressive. Because I'm running out. Yeah. Well, that's going to do more damage to him than the sword is. And I don't want this fight to last forever. Because as you can see, at times it can be rather dangerous. Right, good. Oh god, don't bother. I think if I do a diving attack. There we go. Got him. He did. Right then. Thank you. Got really itchy ears for some reason. But we've found the lens of truth. We can look through it. Mysterious things are hidden everywhere. Be sure to try to use it outside of Be sure to try and use it outside of the well. Seeing the truth will cost magic power, so press the C stick again to stop using it. Well, no. So yes, now we have the power to see what is truth and what is a lie. That's what you get for showing me your belly too many more times. It's like you won't be getting any hot dates tonight with that one. He won't. Doesn't work. Not with me, not with anyone. Oh, hold on. Whoop, I missed a chest. Open the chest. Oh, well, thanks for the bombs. Alright then, carrying on. La 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 la. Oh, right, yeah, I'm out of sticks. I have to hit you with my goddamn sword. But don't worry. You're still showing me that belly. Stop using that tactic your friend told you over there. It doesn't work. We're getting the fudge out of here. It's too scary for me. Resident Evil 7 is tame compared to this place. Well, I don't know. I'm not the measuring stick for that one. Getting a look at that ass, that ass, that ass. Shaky, 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 shaky. How many? I hear another one. Where is he? That's the best place. That's the best thing about this place is it's full of these guys. Hello. Find another one. There. There. Woohoo! Right, how many of does that make it in my collection? I didn't want those. Can you put the boomerang back to that, please? We may as well get this out. Right, I'll just go like this. Play it safe. There's the big old map. It's not that big, but hey. I was supposed to be looking. Where's that screen? I just totally flew over it. 26. I don't think that's enough for another curse to be lifted inside there. So, well, we'll press on. Hello, Mr. Disgusting. Oh, what is it, Navi? Have you ever played the Nocturne of Shadow? The Nocturne of Shadow that Sheik taught you? I have, in a previous game, but not on this one. But don't worry, I will. Yes, unfortunately this is all we have to do as a child. So I have to be a boring old adult again and not a fully optimistic kid. Going, ooh, adventure and fun, woo 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 woo. Just now I'm going, I want a mission. So I have to wait until morning. What a shame that I have to wait until morning. What a pity that I have to wait that long until morning. It's such a shame. It's a long wait ahead of us. Oh wait, never mind. You see the moon literally go. That's like cartoon physics right there. It's morning in Townsville. Sun suddenly pops out of nowhere. Always like doing that, just to see the moon go, fuck, I shouldn't be here anymore! Or the sun, vice versa. We're going back to get out of my way, dog. Stop sniffing my crotch. We're done here, son. We're done. Because we can still use the lens of truth as an adult. So don't have to worry too much. But we've done what needs to be done. So, here we are again. As a kid, picking up the Master Sword. Let's go. We get to relive the magic moment. Ain't it fun? And here we are, as an adult again. Ugh. I'm gonna turn into the fairies from fucking Sleeping Beauty. Ugh, it's blue. Make it pink. No, make it green. Yes, that's what I want. That's better. That's the Link I recognize. Not this blue shit. I'm fully aware that Breath of the Wild, you can have a blue attire. And quite frankly, don't give a poo. That would be nice to have a green one, all the same. Da, 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 and here we are, 7 years into the future once again. Oh. Bye, zombies. You're very fugly. Go away. Don't even know why I'm taking this route. Oh, I think one of the reasons is I'm missing a certain being of great passion. I'm missing my horse. Arr. Calm down. I'm getting on you. And soon we'll be in bed together. Me and you. Blankets, pillows, preferably fluffy. And sex. You are a female horse, after all. Right, let's refrain from going any further with that scene that I've built up in my head. God fucking hell. That Link, he likes a bit of horse. Oh, boy, does he love a bit of horse. Yeah, it's all rainy and stormy around here now, because the evil spirits are free. Now, the reason that Navi did tell us to play the actual tune is, like I said, I don't actually know why I'm actually even taking this trip, because we can instantly teleport to the entrance to the Shadow Temple. I just need to check I've got something in my inventory. Yeah, I got that ages ago. Right. Something else I needed, but I've already got it. We're fine. But it is in the graveyard. It's back there. You see that? You see that fence right up the top there? There's like a door or an archway or whatever. Go away, Poe. I don't like your Edgar Allans. There's, the hole is still here that I made earlier. But yeah, we want to go up there, and obviously we can't do it by other means. So I'm going to have to literally play the tune. And I've forgotten what the fuck it is, so hold on a minute. Where are you, tune? No. Got it. Only to teleport up there. Warp to the graveyard. Yes, you never know. I'm already here.
Whee!
Huzzah! Right then. Yep, here we are. This is how far we travelled. There's the windmill, there's the graveyard. We're up here. Isn't it nice? And here's the grand old entrance to Mr. Shadow Temple, but it seems to be closed. I wonder how I'm going to light all these torches in one swift blow. Get ready for the most magical moment of this game. Probably. I don't know. Anyway, let's do it. Wah! Fire! And then the door rises. Wasn't that great? So yeah, I collected that ages ago from one of the fairies. From one of the great fairy fountains. That power. Called Din's Fire. And here we are. In the glorious Shadow Temple. It's our next dungeon, and it's much better than the stinking Water Temple. Hooray! There we go, it's going to tell us about the Eye of Truth or whatever. The lens. The shadow will yield only to one with the Eye of Truth handed down in Kakariko Village. Well, of course. So, if I actually equip this son of a boo, we'll send it to there. Oh look, the wall is gone because I'm using it. Right then, now that we got that out of the way, and yes, I do actually need it. I can't simply remember where everything fake is because some of the puzzles involve it. Here we go. Make my beak face the skull of truth. The alternative is descent into the deep darkness. So, we have to find the skull that is on top. Look, skull, no skull, skull, no skull. So we have to find the skull that's on top of the post, which so happens to probably be that one there. Yep, no skull. Yep, no skull. Right, it's the one facing the opposite end. And I believe it does change with every time you play, so. See, that's where you need it. A Nintendo, they don't make you skip any steps. Even if it involves something like this. There we go, we're gonna make it face that way. Voila. I'm done. Right. I had to walk away from it. Are you absolutely sure about that? Oh yeah, I'm done. So we'll raise the gate over there. However, we'll read the sign. Hello. Only one who has sacred feet can cross the Valley of the Dead. Only a leap from the lion's head will he prove his worth. I am making too many Indiana Jones references, but hey, I really like that film. Films. Only one of them mainly I like, which is The Last Crusade. But yes, we're going through this wall because it's fake. I remember that at least. We can't yet cross that passage. I don't have enough faith yet. Right. The one who gets the Eye of Truth will be able to see what is hidden in the darkness. Oh look, there's no wall here again. Oh. Now, where's there another hidden wall? Right here. The pots kind of give it away. Shadow Temple. Here is gathered Hyrule's bloody history of greed and hatred. What is hidden in the darkness? Tricks full of ill will. You cannot see the way forwards. You can't see the way forward. Whatever. Same fucking meaning. Right, where's the next? Here's the next one that's fake. So, let's go through the door. Oh, I recognize this place. Huh, this was like at the bottom of the well, except now there's 6 arms instead of 4. 6 arms, eh? Huh. Alright then, let's start this miniature boss fight in a way. He'll be a bit quicker though, because my Master Sword is a bit more powerful, obviously, than a stick. Or the little Kuriki sword that younger version of me is holding. Oi, come here! Nah, he's gonna sink back down. I gotta always summon him by getting grabbed inappropriately by the head. Alright, come here! I'm gonna stab at you with... Oh, hang on. Wow, god, fucking... I didn't mean for that to happen. Okay, I can't actually do that. Right, never mind then. I'm making this battle last longer than it should. Stab him in the head. Yeah. Right then. Oop. Grab me. Grab me good. Right, obviously I don't want to take him on right next to the hands, because otherwise they'll grab me again and he'll have me for lunch. Come here. Ah, got him. See? Much quicker. Only took 3 grabs. And he was dead. And here's a nice large chest. No risk of me falling into this one. I'm bigger. And we have got the hover boots. Woo! With these mysterious boots, you can hover above the ground. The downside? No traction. We turn into Luigi. You can even use these to walk for short periods where there is no solid ground. Be brave and trust in the boots. Yes, we must have faith. We must have faith in the boots. Now, unfortunately, it's back to going here and equipping them. But when the time comes, I will. Luckily, we don't have to have them equipped that often in here, unlike the fucking iron boots for the water temple. The one who gains the Eye of Truth will be able to see what is hidden in the darkness. Yeah, most of these probably repeat themselves. Right, I need to be able to go back to... Ow! Well, where did we come from? Yeah, shut up. Yeah. Good. Whatever. Is it here? This feels like it was this. Yeah, this is back here again. I've gone around in a big old loop. Where's the actual place I need to go to? Oh, here it is. Right then. Here we go. I can't get a bit lost around here. Wait, stop it. Alright, there's another door. I think it leads to somewhere else. Yes, leads to him. Good. Bye bye, Redead. See you later. Huh, I think I can detect a bat around here. Goodbye. Where's the, here we are. You pose no threat to me, good sir? And here's the chest, It's a big one, too. I wonder, is this the map or the compass? It's only gonna be one of the two. It's the map. Right. Carrying on. There, rupee. Mustn't forget that. I need this. Right. This is the way back. Now we're back out here. Righty-ho. So now, if I go and equip the boots, yeah, it's best not to have them on all the time, because otherwise I will tend to slip around like I'm walking on ice. See, like I stopped and I slid a bit, and it's very awkward to control. So we're not going to be wearing them all the time. What I'm going to be doing though is going to be crossing here by going, whoa! There we go, made it to the other side. Now trust me, if we didn't have the boots on, I wouldn't make it. The boots give you that little bit of extra distance. Right, I'm taking these off again now then. It's a BMOs. He needs a bomb in his life. Where are we? Thank you. Starting to think three of us doing, can I do anything then? Right. Yeah. Throw. Bye bye. Oh, I didn't kill him. I need to be a bit more accurate with my throwing here. Thank you. Because that was just going to cause us some trouble. Right, two of these walls are fake. Here we go. Oh, hello, Grim Reaper dudes. The Grim Reaper brothers. We're the Reaper Brothers, and Reaping's our gang. Our game. Fuck, I keep messing up. Ow! So yes, I... Whoa! You could have... Why didn't I shield? There is a way to avoid those if you get caught in the middle. And that's by using your shield, because you duck out, you duck down then. There we go. I have avoided death. Quite literally. Wow! Alright, yeah. Hold on a minute. Yeah, there's a pit down there. But we do... I think there's something down there. There we go. Let's not fall down. Let's use a ladder. That'd be a good idea, wouldn't it? Yeah. Use a fucking ladder. Down, down, down. Down, down, down. Whoops, here we go. Another big old ladder, and I can hear another golden sculpture somewhere. Oh, there wasn't anything down here, but we get to see a few beautiful things around here, like this. Very nice thing around here. It's very nice, not really, but there we go. Oh, good. Came down here for nothing. Right, going up. This is a very linear dungeon, I find. Like, you progress from A to B quite easily. There's there may be a few things here and there to sidetrack you, but otherwise it's a fairly straightforward. I mean, just look at the map. Yeah, we've got a fairly just straightforward going through stuff air kind of place. Just a few side bits here and there. This being one of them. Right, let's pick up that. Because all of these are bloody reset, because I didn't pick them all up the first time around. Darn it. Ah! There. Right. Boop. Thank you. Nope, hang on. Where's the other one? These over there. Boop. I shouldn't be walking against these. It's like driving against traffic, you know? There's something not to be done. Let's have that. And then we can hookshot our way up there. and then pick up this one. That was nice pick up there, Link. Right. There we go. Oh, God, I just got my neck cut off. Bye-bye, Link's head. Nice knowing you. You'll get a head on life, but only if you have one. Best go around the outside for now, and then go in here and open up chest number one to get small key number one. Ooh, lovely. So yes, that's what we came in here for. Right, but now I can leave. Good day. Hold on. A good day to you, Grim Reaper. Don't know why I got that hat down there. Oh, Mr. Laser is back, so I'm gonna wipe him out again. Bombs. Bombs. Throw a bomb. And he blows up. No, he doesn't blow up. Kill him, bastard. Yikes. Okay, the way forward is actually that way. But, you're thinking, that wall isn't real. Well, it is. But, it can be gotten past. I've got to kill this mummy first, who thinks he's a re-dead. It's adorable. There's another one over here who thinks he's a re-dead. But he's not. He's a mummy. Don't know what's a mummy doing down here. When did you start getting all Egyptian up on my ash? I wonder what's in this one. Could it be the map or could it be the compass? Well, considering we've already got the map, then it must be the compass. Right then. Off we go. And now he's going to be back once again, so I'll just come out with a bomb. Ah! Oh, for fuck's sake. Ugh, wasting my bombs on you. No, that's not going to work either. Oh, maybe it is. Okay. I'll shut up. Thanks for the bombs back. Right, this is a wall, except, obviously, we can blow the fuck out of it. Goodbye. And here's the locked door to the key I just got. So, see, I needed the key. I told you. Wow. Well, then, you came out of nowhere. Skull chiller out of nowhere. Oh, another one. See, they've hidden them now up into the ceiling, so you can't actually see them until they come down. You can't see them just hanging around above you. They come down like that, out of the ceiling. Hello, goodbye. The thing you got to look out for is quite literally their shadows. Right then. Oh, these look pretty. These look very pretty. Whoa! Hazards. I love it. Oh, hello again, out of nowhere. Right then. I guess they're the jump scares for this game. They serve as them. Hi, Navi, what's up? Watch for the shadows of monsters that hang from the ceiling. Stop being so dramatic. That's only here, anyway. Right then. Another bit of hazard avoiding. Man, too much death around here. But then again, that's to be expected. We're in the goddamn Shadow Temple. Death comes naturally around here. Hi, bouncing bubble of death. I think I actually need the hover shoes just to get over there. There's all these little bits of tricks that Nintendo have laid out in this dungeon. Right then, so I've got to move. Right, good. Right, I am not taking you on with these. Right then, we're facing off with another one of these guys. A lot of the people back from the forest temple that we encountered. The monsters from the ceiling and these fucking dudes. Hi there, come on. We're going to be meeting some more of these guys a bit later. But this is the first example of one. Okay, hello. What are you doing? Having a dance? I don't want to move around a lot because this is very limited space we're on right now. Go on, I'm ready for you, bitch. Ah, fucking. Okay, I've got him in the spine. It could have been a real nasty situation, but luckily I managed to stab him in the spine. Okay, more Lens of Truth power. Bah! There's the unseen layers around here. And I can still walk on them when I turn it off, look. Oh look, I'm walking on nothing. Spooky, innit? Right then. Oh, yeah, so now we need to use it again. Huh, this big empty room. Oh, it's not so empty. It's got a couple of Grim Reapers, they return. Again, hello there, good sirs. I see you're swinging around with your scythes. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to kill like with that. Wah! Don't, bleh. Don't suck on me. I don't taste nice. I'm not a lollipop. I'm not Link the Lollipop, even though it's got quite a good ring to it. Link the Lollipop, Link the Lollipop. Right, I need to... I can do with those hearts, especially now as a bat has attacked me. Why do I keep pressing the wrong button? Hold on, you're not getting away with that. Told you. Right. There should be more bats around here. Hello. On the walls. On the walls, ice cream. They get higher for that stuff. There we go. There's another one. Getting high off the walls. Get it? Getting high off the walls because they're high up on the wall. I don't fucking know. Right. Now we can go through this gate. Just have to stay out of the area where the Grim Reapers are. Don't matter about being able to see them, that was just the trick. If you can't hear them with the rotating noise, or if you don't recognize that rotating noise because you can hear it, but you can't see them, and you won't realize, oh, they're in the middle of the room, and then you suddenly start getting mysteriously damaged. I got a blue ruby! It's worth 5. And also I got this. Thank you very much. Lovely. Right, I think I need them back for this because I just want to run across the room. Get out of that, please. Right then. But yes, this will use up my magic, so I'm not having. That's why I'm not having it on all the time, in case you're wondering that question. Because it does use up a bit of the old magic power up there. So I will refrain. Look at me do magic. Look at me do magic. Look at me do magic. Now I could take on Skull and Crossbones here again. But I don't think I'll bother. See you later. Oh god, no, not, that's the wrong time! Supposed to do it when that platform is below. Not above. Right, hold on, I'll wait until they give up with that stupid noise of them lifting up into the air by the chains. Okay, and I think I do need the hover boots on again as well, just in case. Hi, get out of the way! Oh, not again. Well, we're sucking. Unintentionally. Yeah, I'll just hover over now, I don't care. These platforms are nice and big anyway. Da 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 da. Right, Now at least he's where we want him to be. Down there. There we go. Perfect timing. Didn't have any timing whatsoever there, but it was perfect. Right. I think I'll leave them on for a little moment. I haven't got anything much trouble to deal with. But the Lens of Truth will lend a hand here. On these platforms that move left and right. Because they're invisible. Oh, we need another key. Never mind, I'll come back. I don't need it here. I think we get the key over there. I'll take the shoes off. I can't be sliding around here. Not with these things. Right. Oh, I need a bomb as well. Give me the bomb. Right then. One bomb! Coming up. Oh god, I missed. Oh, don't worry, he's dead. Never mind, crisis averted. There, where'd you come? Ah! Just missed me. Way, and then the door opens, and then I don't know where it leads to, so yeah. Oh, I know exactly where this leads to. Oh, well, how am I supposed to go? Oh yes, well, I'll come back to this. Because this is a little challenging little room in here, with these horrible things falling down. I'm feeling like this is very Sonic the Hedgehog-ish. Marble Zone, anyone? Who's played that Sonic, the first Sonic game ever made? Or maybe not made, but the first one that came out for, whatever, Sonic fucking 1. But it's time for me to call it a day here. I haven't got enough time to press on in this dungeon. This delightful dungeon full of delightful dark treats. But it will return, because I'm going to thank everyone for watching this part. I hope you enjoyed it. And there will be more of this to come next weekend. Oh yes, things are getting spoopy. Indeed. But yes, I will see you however and whenever. Good day and goodbye. Don't forget to die. That's a horrible thing to say at the end there, Aki. Oh well, I'm going with it. I'm sticking with it, so screw you. Yeah. Alright. Bye-bye!